Good late afternoon, good evening from the Gettysburg National Battlefield. And I am your host, Ripped Van Winkle. That's right, otherwise known as Ripcord. I'm gonna fly around, have some fun. I'm loving this little flight sim. And if you're tuning in an hour later, thanks for tuning in. I'm not sure how long I'm going to be on. I'm not feeling well and I'm pretty tired, but I'm hanging in there. I'm gonna fly around, so I thought I would have anyone join me. So welcome. Is my mic on? I think it is. Good afternoon. What's happening, buddy? Thanks for the message, by the way. It's always nice to see you. It's always nice to see you. I could be doing better, but I'm all right. I'm feeling very strange today. How are you? How's your Sunday? I hope you're resting and relaxing. Let's take a look at this. Have you ever played this? Thank you. Me neither. I'm just, my body can't decide whether or not it wants to stay awake. And so it's been a struggle all day to just try to freaking stay awake so I can hang out with you guys and have fun. Drive me bananas with narcolepsy. I got a lot done today, though. I got a lot of chores done today. I got a lot cleaned up. I got the balcony all cleaned up so we can go outside and live stream whatever we want. Got some trash taken care of, the dishes taken care of, got some boxes broken down. So I got a lot done. It's just, it wears me out. And how are you? Relaxing? Not doing much of anything? Hope you're playing a game. I saw your alert for Kick. And thank you so much for your help with Kick and the suggestions and answering my questions. I appreciate it. And I'm really liking this flight sim, this flight sim. It's super. Yeah, I'm really digging this. The performance on this is amazing and the graphics are amazing. And again, the performance is outstanding. And essentially this is IL-2, Birds of Prey, which was on PlayStation, but it was ported to PC by another company that was hired by Oleg Maddox. So this was ported by Gaijin, and I think that they did a outstanding job on the performance and an outstanding job on the graphics. The flight models, and there's a few things about the planes that could definitely use improvement, but I'm really enjoying it. I'm digging it, and welcome. Right on. I hope you're having a relaxing day. I'm trying to stay awake and stay functional as long as I can. It's a beautiful day outside. It's weird. It doesn't know if it wants to be cold or hot. What's the weather like there? Because it was really nice out earlier, but now it's like it's gotten cold. It's like we had a cold front come in or something. I went from wearing shorts and a t-shirt to wearing like pants and long sleeve shirt and a button down. So weird. I don't know if it's just me or what. I'm feeling kind of strange. Narcolepsy and MS and all that stuff, you know? 76, yeah, it is, but I would need like a hoodie or a sweatshirt now, which is, I keep looking at my cam up there. Yeah, it's strange. It's probably like, it went from like 75 to like 50 within an hour, it seems like it. But I was outside, I got stuff cleaned up, the balcony, we can go outside in the balcony whenever we want. In and out of bed, man, I'm sick of it. I just want to stay awake like a normal person. So I can, you know, I'm working on my scenes, I'm gonna play some games. So what are you doing today? Eating some good food? Playing some good games, I hope. What else do I have for you guys in here? All kinds of nutty stuff. Yeah, right here. Yeah, that was fun. Name that intro theme and I will buy you a copy of the game that it came from. Come on, guys. I've done this before the past couple of years. Name that game theme. One of the best World War II flight sims of the 90s. That's right. Ah, doesn't that sound just make the hair go up in the back of your neck? Kick the chocks and spin the props. Let's kick the rust off these old birds and shoot down some Nazis. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. Rock and roll. Hot dog. Mikator, it's always good to see you, man. I hope to get to meet you in person someday. Let's jump in here. I'm really digging this. I'm really liking this game. This is a little strange. I wanted to comment while we're just beginning this stream, and this is the very first broadcast that I've ever broadcasted Wings of Prey, which is the PC port from PlayStation of IL-2 Birds of Prey. And it was ported by a company that was hired by Oleg Maddox, Gaijin. And I think they did a pretty good job, except for... In most games, we have easy, we have normal, and we have expert or hard. in this game, in this rendition, I should say, of IL2, it leans a little more on the arcade side, where the flight models are pretty doggone good. For example, when I play on Expert, when I play on Simulator, the clockwise rotary pull is too strong. I probably spent 1,000,000 hours in flight sims. I've played more flight sims than anything on PC in 40 years. And the pull on the rotary engine is too strong. The damage model is off just a tad, but it's not enough to turn me off of the game. And what I mean is even if you play this on easy, normal, or expert, which is simulator, normal is realistic, easy is arcade. You'll see when we get into the game. The damage models, what I mean is, and a lot of people have reported this, I've been on SimHQ for years, for decades, and a lot of the guys who were reviewing this were looking at it and said the same thing, the same kind of findings that I found, where the enemy are deadly, regardless of what level you're playing this at. It seems like the enemy are really deadly. It's like one-shot kills. So, like the old German saying goes, he who shoots first lives longest, and that's an old Luftwaffe saying, he who shoots first lives longest. And so while the simulatory expert mode, the flying of the plane is, the rotary pull is even stronger than IL-2, and IL-2 is a very good flight sim. In my opinion, IL-2 is probably the best combat flight sim in the last 20 years, the whole series. And that's what I primarily play is IL-2 when it comes to combat flight sims. But this game, like I said, it leans a little on the arcade side. It's kind of easy to fly. The only peeves I had, I should say, I'll try to make a long story short, from the king of making a short story long, the rotary pull on the expert settings is too strong. The enemies are deadly shots, and the enemy planes, and I'm playing on normal for the most part, realistic settings, they're tanks. And so I'm getting popped once with a 30 millimeter right in my Rolls-Royce engine, and I'm done. I think I've gotten killed a couple of times, and I'm flying training missions, getting my dust off my wings. And so yeah, I'm getting, the enemy planes seem a little tankish. I'm opening up on these tanks with thousands of rounds. They should be Swiss cheese. They should be in the English Channel. Regardless of what, if I play it on arcade, expert, or realistic, they're tanks. And the enemies, regardless of what skill level you're playing on, they'll pop you with just a few shots. They'll take you out. And so it is challenging in that regard. One strange thing that I found that was very different, there's just really minor little peeves that are different than IL-2. For example, I'm flying this on realistic settings, but I don't have any controls over my wheel brakes. I don't have controls over a lot of my flying surfaces, like flaps, and I use flaps in combat, landing, and takeoff. I use them as air brakes. And there's just some things like that, that the computer controls those things, the AI controls those things for you. I wouldn't consider that realistic, which is why I said it leans a little on the arcade side. Because I'm somebody, I use my wheel brakes, I use my flaps, and I use them in combat. That kind of stuff, like wheel brakes, will save me from crashing and nosing over. And I've also noticed I probably landed, and I hope my volume is okay, hope the music's not too loud, and this is some nice remastered 1920s tunes. In any event, the enemies, bonsai to you, Itchy. What's up, Jam Man? I missed your stream, buddy. I'm sorry. I saw you were on, but I've been in and out of bed. Good to see ya. What's up, bitchy? How's it going? You were playing something different than I'd never seen you play before. Diabolical Itchy Jam. And so, these aircraft and Itchy, how are you? And it's all good. Right on. Duder. I love it. The planes are tanks. I'm looking at my cam up here. The planes are tanks. They'll nail you with one-shot kills regardless of what settings you're playing on. The flight models lean a little towards arcade with the exception of simulator. Simulator, I think, is a little over the top in regard to some of the flight characteristics. But again, this was a game that was contracted to Gaijin by Oleg Maddox and IL2 to port this PlayStation game over to PC, and I enjoy it. The one thing where Gaijin completely shined on this port is the performance. This, I can crank this up and it flies like a rocket. So the performance and the graphics, for the graphics to look as good as they do, and for this game to perform this well, Gaijin really knew what they were doing. They didn't know what they were doing so much in regard to damage models and flight models, but the performance and coding with the textures and the interaction of the animations is just outstanding. They did a really good job, which will keep me playing this game in spite of the little peeves that I have about the control surfaces of the aircraft. I'd like to use the flaps. I like to use the wheel brakes. The plane seems to, it performs differently than I'm used to flying airplanes over the last 30 years. For example, the airspeed versus the altitude, the climb rate. Look at you, USAF vet. Fill me in, Pagan. How's your day, Itchy, and how are you doing? I think I see monkeys playing bongos. I can't see too well. Right on. And if you guys are still there, thanks for chilling. Demonologist, that's it, right there. So I'm gonna fly around. Eventually I'll start a campaign. We'll check out this beautiful scenery. We'll fly around Dover. We'll go see if we can find Tongue Gate, the village of my ancestors. And thanks for chilling, you guys. I hope you are having an excellent, excellent Sunday. It's Sunday. I haven't forgotten what day it is today. Right on, Stream Elements. Welcome, Stream Elements. Good afternoon, Stream Elements. What's for dinner, y'all? Bill Gates isn't eating my freaking ice cream. Oh, NVIDIA took a poop again. Connection. Thank you, Stream Elements. You're a total freak show. Sing it if you know it. It's like a bunch of little flying monkeys marching to the buffet. This is the theme song. They will live forever. Friends of mine, we founded the very first flight sim squadron on the internet, and it was called the Flying Circus, and that was 31, 32 years ago. And some of those friends that I found, that we co-founded that squad with, went on to work for Oleg Maddox and IL2 Games. And those friends of mine that I flew with 30 years ago were some of the developers for IL2's new Flying Circus, which is the number one game on Warlord's list that I want to play. I want to play that Flying Circus, man. And then the Parisno standalone game. I hope that volume's okay, you guys. Let's check it all out. Yeah, so cool. Let's see how we've done so far. Missions completed, two missions. I've done two training missions, right? I'm just flying around, kicking off the dust, kicking off the rust, kicking out the chocks and spinning the props. Let's go, fighter. 28 kills, two missions. No way, bullshit. Let's check out what we got in our arsenal. Yeah, all right, let's check them out. Groovy, groovy, boy, that's close. What's going on here? Whoa, why is this so close? This is acting a little weird. This shouldn't be so zoomed in. That's was different. Let's see where we're sitting here. That shouldn't have been so zoomed in. Why was it so zoomed in? Hey Jen, what the heck is what's going on with this here? Let's see. Yeah, this isn't zooming out. I could be better, Jen, but I'm okay. I'm not really sure. I'm just sick 1 minute and I'm okay the next. This is, why is this so zoomed in? This should be showing us the whole hangar. What's going on with this view? This is weird. Yeah, this isn't acting right. This is acting strange. Let's reload this. Owen Wright was born in Red Hill in 1920, joined the RAF Volunteer Reserve in January 37. Hey, Dr. Greenbuds, what's happening? No, there is no FOV settings, Jen. It's a menu, and it just changed for the first time ever. I saw that. It was fine the past couple of days. Let me see something here. And I cannot exit out of the game into chat because the game will lock up. And so if I come into chat, I have to exit the game. Thank you, Jen. There isn't any settings like that. Let me see something here. Try it again. What's happening, you guys? Good to see you. I hope you guys are having a good Sunday. We'll try that again. What's up? I'm flying some planes, trying to stay out of bed. Trying to get some things cleaned up around here. Yeah, that was weird. I don't know why it did that. It should have given us a pan back view of the planes, and it didn't. So I'll just try it again. Good to see you guys. How's your day? It's Sunday evening at 7 o'clock, and welcome. Boy, it was warm out earlier. I'm really wiped out. I got a lot of chores done today, so I'm pretty tired. And it's nice of you guys to roll in here. Could have been caused by Windows auto scaling. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Something like that, yeah. That's strange that it just did that out of the blue. So let's have another look. Everything's groovy. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Everything's fine. My vision sucks today. Right on. Good to see you guys. Thank you so much. McGator stopped in. It you go. Dr. Greenbuds, high five. It you go, Dr. Greenbuds, Jen. I know Dark's hanging around somewhere. He's probably playing GTA. McCater. Let's see where I'm at. Yeah, the options don't... We can't do graphics once we're in. We'll take a look anyway. Yeah, it's like super zooming in. It, like, let's see. Reset view. Let's reset the view. There's a view reset. Let's see if I can reset that view. That's weird. I don't know why it's doing that. I wanted to look at the airplanes. We will. There's a reset view. Reset camera, middle mouse button. You see, it's fucking not doing to do shit for me, you bastards. Zoom out. Want to look at the whole hangar? We should be able to see the whole hangar. For some reason, it's not showing us the whole hangar. It's like really zoomed in. But on the upside, you see the upside? The upside is the number on the plane is 42. You know it's going to be a good day because everybody knows that is the answer to the ultimate question. 42. Ask A5 Beeblebrox, he'll tell you. So let's check it out. So we're looking at the bombers, maybe once we get down to Hurricane. So we'll be flying today. How about my joystick? Let's see. Nope, joystick won't have anything to do with the views. Using my Microsoft. I've been using this stick for freaking 25 years. Right on, so let's see what we got. We'll be flying a Hurricane today for a while. I'm gonna show you guys around. Come on, load, let's go. Move it, come on game. Let's go Oleg Maddox, make it happen. Now of course this is made by IL2. And if you guys are just tuning in, oh, look at that, that's just awesome. Oh yeah, that's bitching. Oh yeah, that's so cool. And so this was made by IL2. This is made by Oleg Maddox, okay? And this was IL-2 Birds of Prey on PlayStation, but it was never made for PC. And so IL-2 hired Gaijin, and they ported this over to PC, and I really like it. So my point is, it's going to be very Russian IL-2 heavy aircraft. But let's get right to the British, right? Because we're not going to be flying any IL-2 Russian aircraft anytime soon. And I'll show you why. The campaign's really interesting. One of the big draws for PC games, especially flight sims, any military game. I wonder what's up with the view. Why won't the view zoom out? Come on, zoom out, you punk. Yeah, it's weird. It should zoom out. It's I don't understand why. But in any event, so there's going to be a lot of Russian aircraft in here. And we have several... I broke my real old joystick, Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. You guys want to watch the original? I have it on VHS. My vision is terrible every day outside of dark mode. Yeah, man. Yeah, me too, Jen. The same. He usually pops up when you say his name. Parisno. If somebody could hit in the chat !WOP. If you guys are interested in playing this game, do not buy it from Steam. You'll be throwing your money away. The Steam version of this game cannot be activated. You can't play it. But Steam continues to sell it. So thank you very much, Jen. Yeah, so if you guys want to get this game and you want to get the whole kit and caboodle and it does run, this game only cost me $10. The game's about 5-10 years old. Looks super, runs super. It performs amazingly. As you'll see, in any event, get it from Gaijin, from the company, or get it from GOG. I got mine from Good Old Games. And I don't use the GOG Galaxy. I don't like to use Steam. I don't like to use third-party crap running in the background. Fucking keylogger. That's one more dollar in the MS swear jar, baby. And Dr. Greenbuds, owe you a puff. Dude, take me to the Derby next time. Dr. Greenbuds went to the races, man. He went to the freaking kick-ass dirt track races. I freaking love local races. Our bitchin'. Dude, it was nice out this morning. It was so nice out this morning, you guys. Jin, what's it like up there where you're at? Let's do Flying Tigers, you guys. And I fly IL-2 1946. And I also fly Red Baron 3D, Promised Land. Right on. So whoever names the theme song to the intro of this broadcast, I will buy you the game that theme song comes from. Right on, P-47. Let's check them out. Yeah, this is weird. I don't know why the view's doing that. Oh, look at that bad boy. You guys like airplanes? You guys fly flight sims? What's your favorite flight sim? Look at that. Oh, man, that's freaking hot. It's a freaking gun with an engine. Oh, I love it. Look at all the kills on his propeller. Right on, let's go. So the campaign is interesting. I love campaign. You have to actually play the war. The campaign is locked, so you have to play through the war. So you actually play every theater of operations in order. So we have to complete the Battle of Britain, July, October 1940, before we can move on to Sicily, Russia, Battle of the Bulge, and we'll take a look at all the campaigns too. I want to show this off. I'm enjoying this. Oh, look at that. Oh, I love the biplanes, the triplanes, the prop planes. I love it. Look at that. You guys ever flown one of these old birds, man? I've flown in a bunch of old birds. Highly recommended. Add it to your bucket list. Cole Palin's Old Rhinebeck Aerodrome in Red Hook, New York. It's right up by Albany. You guys put that on your bucket list, you'll be glad you did. Go to the weekend when they have the fly-in. It's the largest collection of World War I aircraft in the world. Cole Palin spent shit about 100 years collecting this stuff. All the old World War I airplanes that you guys have seen in Hollywood over the last 100 years, right back to Howard Hughes' film Hell's Angels, which was the very first piece of color film ever seen in a movie theater, is when the Zeppelin lights up on fire in the film Hell's Angels, the World War I film. Howard Hughes, great film. The German is horrible. They make a caricature out of the German language. It was weird. Because I use my flight stick. Pedal, yeah, I can't use the pedals. Perfect wingman. It's nice today. Right on. Dude, it was nice out earlier. I got a bunch of stuff. The balcony's all cleaned up. We can start live streaming outside. I got all the stuff up. Got some cardboard boxes broke up. Got some trash out. The thing is, it's just an hour of activity. Puts me on my ass for 5 hours. My legs are killing me. Yak, 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 yak. What else we got? What else we got? What do the Axis have? Araro, look at this. Oh, that's so cool. You notice they took the Swazis off. They took the swastikas off. They put X's on them. I just put more. I would just replace those X's with just more German crosses. You see the X on the tail? Just mirror the cross onto the tail. That's what we used to do in IL-2. And also modding this, I don't know, because the files are all Xbox. They're like Xbox port files. I looked at the files because I wanted to mod some of the skins, right? I wanted to put some cool tags and shit on there. I could put you guys' channel icons on there, right? And the files are, I've never worked with those files. They're like Xbox files. Some of you guys would probably recognize them. And this is some soup. Look at that. Oh, gosh, that's so cool. I can't freaking wait to fly down in the Mediterranean, Sicily, man. Operation Husky. Oh, it's going to be bitching. And you guys, I have some really good stories to share with you guys. Mysteries of World War II. I got a pretty good collection of books. And I got some really good stories in some of these books that are really mysterious. G10 baby, right on the K4. Look at that. Oh, that's so hot. Look at that. So bitchin'. Where's Eric Hartman when you need him? Booby, the little boy. Greatest German ace of the war. Look at that. Yeah, we're going to do all kinds of crazy missions. These are loading slow. I don't know why they load slow in the menus. Boy, they sure look good. And granted, what message did it black on me? I don't know what you mean, buddy. Block. You don't have any messages blocked. You don't have any messages blocked, Jen. You don't ever say anything that gets you blocked. You're polite and cordial. Because I threatened to eat everything in your refrigerator. Didn't block any messages. Right on, you guys. Let's look around some more. I had some grilled cheese today. What did you guys have to eat? A Hello Fresh box. Right on. What was I just saying? I don't know. So I get used to it. My fridge will be full soon. That's it. Hey, what's happening? Good Yostra to you. Is it baby making day? It's baby making day. Yostra. And so when the forsythias turn yellow, then Yostra comes. And when Yostra comes, we have a big feast. And we drink, we fuck, and we fight for a whole week. That's Yostra. It's baby making day. Wait till Tuesday. Jin, you're totally throwing me off. What's happening, son? How are you? And good Easter to you, too. Thank you very much. Spring is here. My mom made a ham, dude. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Can't beat a ham. How does she make the ham? Do any of you guys, when you make a ham, do you guys put the little cloves in there? In the ham? I always liked those, man. Those were good. Dude, that sounds good, son. Can I come over? I'll be nice. I will. Look at that. Oh, man. Look at that. So cool. Junkers. All right. We're going to do some Stuka. We're going to freaking do some Stuka bombing. And so this also has the Wings of the Luftwaffe DLC. And so this has the extra Luftwaffe DLC. But most reviewers, like I said earlier, I've been on SimHQ for many, many, many years. And the guys didn't have too much good things to say about the Luftwaffe DLC. And so you can play an entire campaign as a German with the DLC. Oh, that's so awesome. That's so awesome. And there's a four-person co-op in this. And I'm curious to see if anyone has... Oh, look at that. Look at that. It's got my freaking rooster right on the side, baby. Oh, so cool. I'm freaking out. You guys, man. What's the coolest airplane that you've ever sat in? I was one of the last people to ever sit in the Concorde. In the pilot seat of the Concorde. I was probably one of the last five people that ever sat in the seat of the Concorde. No shit. A buddy of mine who actually worked on Flight Sims, one a developer back 30 years ago, a buddy of mine, James Romano, was one of the security guards for the Concorde, and he got us on the Concorde before it was decommissioned. One of the other coolest planes I've ever sat in was the reproduction of the Albatross D5A that was flown by Edward Ritter von Schley, the Black Knight of Bavaria, in World War I. He's one of my favorite pilots. He has such an interesting history. And I got to sit in that plane at Cole Palin's old Rhinebeck Aerodrome. You guys ever get a chance to go there, man, I highly recommend it, man. You guys will see one of the only operational Renault World War I tanks in existence, and they drive it around and everything. It's sop with camels there, all kinds of great stuff. And granted, it's World War I. I'm a bigger World War I fan than I am a World War II fan. I know a great deal about World War I, where World War II, I'm no expert. I'm just like the next guy. I'm just like the next Homer Simpson. So dig it. Where are we at? Logbook? How we doing? 28 freaking kills, 2 missions. Bullshit. Lies. Absolute lies. JG1 Wolfgang flies again. 1 million kills, baby. These guys are going to hand my ass to me. Missions, profile, options, extras. What do we got for extras? Let's check it out. Encyclopedia. Stunts. Awesome. So what do we got? Barrel roll, inside loop. Immelmann. Who was Immelmann? Who was Immelmann? The Eagle of Leo. The Eagle of Leo. Google that. You guys will be glad you did. Immelmann was a pioneer, man. He's one of the very first aces in history. Immelmann, the Eagle of Leo. He's one of the very first aces to shoot down 5 French planes. And he always had a smile on his face. And he invented the Immelmann. And thanks for tuning in, listening to my yammer. World War German ace Max Immelmann, right on. Died in 1916. Got shot down. Bitchin'. Tactics, tactics, interface. What do we got? This is so strange. This is so very different. It's so interesting. The pilot section contains a list of pilots in your flight. And so, like, if I have a flight where I have 4 pilots, and you guys, if that music is too loud, can somebody please let me know? I've been on way more Navy vessels than planes. Awesome, man. Awesome, awesome. And Ichigo is former USAF. A lot of my friends on Twitch, probably half of... Right on. Thank you, Jen. You're always lying, because whenever I listen to my stream later, you can't hear me talk. You can only hear the music. It's just how you want it, huh? And I forgot what I was saying. Jen, what's the biggest ship that you've been on? What's the biggest ship that you've been on, dude? Dude, do you know the, you know those great big giant transports? They look like a landing, they are a landing craft, but they're massive, really massive. The giant landing craft where like they drive tanks onto it and shit. And it's almost like 2 stories up. You can walk around the top. It's like a big landing craft. I've been on, that's probably the biggest vessel that I've been on, as one of those gigantic landing crafts. Me too. Yeah, I was on a little wolf sub when I was a kid, sitting on the deck. It was for the bicentennial, 1976. In 1976, we had a little wolf, little sub, I don't know what you would call it, in Chicago, right outside in our small town, came down the Chicago River. And so all the kids, the sub let all the kids on the deck, and it took us for rides up and down the Illinois River. We were waving at Tom Sawyer and Huck Finn. It was awesome. My brother-in-law designs and inspects the ships that you worked on. And so my brother-in-law flies all over the world for the last 30 years, and he is one of the top engineers for the Navy who inspects, designs, builds ships all over the world for the U.S. Navy. That's what he does. Bubba. Bubba. Makes a bitchin' homebrew too, my brother-in-law. Right on, you guys, history. I love the sea. I love the sea, I love the land, I love the air, I love the earth. Battle of Britain, right on. Look at this, guys, this is where we're going. This is what we got. We got Battle of Stalingrad. Invasion of Sicily, I can't wait. That's gonna be awesome, invasion of Sicily. The Canadians suffered 2,400 casualties, 500 killed. Horrible. Two Ukrainian fronts managed not only to inflict serious casualties to the German forces inside the salient. Right on, we got Battle of the Bulge, Battle of Berlin. These are all the campaigns. We have to play them in this order. We have to unlock them. I'm gonna have to gank these background videos for our chat scenes. Right on. And so, cool, cool, cool. And I'm still looking at some of this stuff too. Some of the stuff I haven't looked at yet. Replays. Was this my first one? I probably got my ass arcade, realistic. I think I got my ass handed to me. Welcome to Warlord's Hangar. This is a replay. I think I played this right before I went live. I'm sitting in my cockpit rolling a joint. Look at that IG, man. Right on. Did work on that one in 1998. The cool 1998, then you may have indeed met my brother-in-law. You may have indeed met my brother-in-law. 1998. The coolest one ever. So, dude, in 1998, were you down in Tidewater? Were you down in Norfolk at the naval shipyards? Because that's where I was living. I was down in Virginia Beach. We had moved down to Virginia Beach in 97 when my daughter was born. It's good timing. Keep your heads on a roll. I'm not flying, guys. This is a replay. But we're going to get flying. We're going to fly around, have a look around. This is a replay from just a little while ago. Whoa, 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 whoa. Yeah, see, it's so strange when I have control of my landing gear, but I do not. But when I raise my landing gear, it then also controls the flaps and the wheel brake. It's weird. It's arcade-ish. I would rather have control over my over everything, but I don't want that rotary pull with the super realistic, and I don't want the one-shot freaking kills. This sucker popped me right in the cowling, man, with a great big fat freaking 30 millimeter round. No shit, he knocked me out of commission. Yeah, so we're flying, and I think I went up to intercept a couple of Heinkels. Look at the graphics, you guys. Not bad for an older game, huh? I'll tell you what, I wish IL-246, I play IL-246 a lot. I wish it performed like this. I wish the graphics looked this good, but they just don't. IL-2-1946 is a good simulator. But the graphics and the performance don't compare. It doesn't. So right on, guys. Thought I'd show a little bit. Look around a little bit. So we got replays. That's pretty cool. Credits, encyclopedia, encyclopedia, encyclopedia. I think we already looked at that. Stunts, tactics, history. What else? Credits. Who's on here? Wings of Prey. It's all guys with JG1 on their freaking, on their names. Nice. Let's get flying, huh? There was something else. Exit, options, profile, missions, main menu. Options, profile, missions, options. General audio controls. There was something else. Profile, logbook hanger. There was, I want to show you guys the campaign. All right, so we got tutorial. I haven't even looked at this tutorial. Eventually I will. I'm beating my chest here, right? I'm rustling my own jimmies. But I don't really think I need a tutorial, but I will go through it. I will look at it. Yeah, I'm just kind of winging it. Yeah, tutorial campaign, single missions campaign. Let's check it out. So the campaign, we can do this, right? And so you see with the campaign, this is our campaign. And this is the one thing that really interests me in any game is a campaign, right? You start out at the bottom of the barrel, you work your way up, right? You earn your keep. That's the kind of game I like. And all my games, don't matter what it is.
1939.
And so we have to finish each campaign in order to unlock the other campaigns. Nazi Germany
takes over Czechoslovakia and invades Poland. Denmark and Norway.
This is Jin Chaos's only cameo in video game history.
And yet more countries
are devoured by the Third Reich. This is Jin's other voice.
The French government surrenders on the 22nd of June.
When he was even newer.
The British Expeditionary Force, crushed on the battlefield, barely escapes at Dunkirk. Germany is victorious yet again, and World War II enters a new stage.
He's always airing out his pits.
Great Britain remains the only country in Europe that stands against Nazi Germany.
Be right back. Second I get off the boat, I get ill.
Separated from mainland Europe by the English Channel, the British Isles are temporarily safe from the German Blitzkrieg. Britain is fully aware that the first strike will come from the air. It is well prepared for that. A complex defensive infrastructure of detection, command, and control, known as the Dowding System, gives the Royal Air Force a serious advantage. The RAF is a multinational force, with pilots not only from the British Commonwealth, but also from Poland, Czechoslovakia, France, Belgium, and other British allies.
American Volunteers, Eagle Squadron.
By the 13th of July, 1940, Hitler personally approves Operation Sea Lion, calling for a full-scale invasion.
Did you guys see Dunkirk, the film Dunkirk? I thought it was fantastic.
Sir Winston Churchill, the British Prime Minister,
was it Greyhound with Tom Hanks? Good fleck.
We shall go on to the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be.
Can you imagine?
We shall fight on
like
the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and the streets, we shall fight in the hills, we shall never surrender. Within days, thousands of German bombers and fighters would set course for England to try to break the British resistance. A handful of young men in the Royal Air Force would stand between Hitler and the total domination of Europe. Never in the field of human conflict had so much depended on so few.
Right on. So we have to unlock everything in order before we can get to Stalingrad. In Sicily, I really want to play. The Sicily is going to be great. Operation Husky, that's going to be cool. They even got lawnmowers. I'm set. Corson Pocket, awesome. Battle of the Bulge, nuts. Tiger Hunt, pesticide. Battle of Berlin, awesome. Pardon me. Single missions. Take our pick. Now, the thing is I don't think that these missions... Yeah, these missions are not the same missions as in the campaign. They're different. And I'm still playing the... it says training, but it's missions. So I'm flying realistic. We're going to fly Dover. No artillery. this is another peeve. This is bullshit. It doesn't work. It just simply doesn't work. I have tried this setting right here, the situational setting, and it just doesn't work. Equal altitude, it doesn't work. They always have an altitude advantage. They will always have an altitude advantage. Every mission I've played. There we go. Every mission I've played, they've had an altitude advantage. I mean, I'll set it to like 3,000 feet, 5,000 feet. The Germans will fly in with Heinkels. They're at like 10,000, 11,000, 14,000 feet. So I don't know. Doesn't work. This works. This was bitching. This was totally cool. This morning when I got up, I put on the thunderstorm and I flew through the thunderstorm. Holy shit, man. That was really cool. There was this. And what I was saying earlier was, please don't judge this game by my mediocre quality stream, my broadcast, because my broadcast is mediocre, but what lies before me is not. What lies before me is high def on a 42-inch screen, and it looks bitchin'. Dr. Greenbuds will tell you it looks bitchin'. I can see the freaking, you guys have all seen it, right, on your fat systems? The beads of the water just on the glass, just blowing right off the freaking, right off the plane. And you can't see, you have no visibility. Right, and oh man, I'm just looking at my horizontal. I'm looking at my horizontal indicator, and I'm like, I'm just totally guessing. I'm watching my altitude, my airspeed, and I'm just like, wow. And the storm was really cool. And then you guys, if you guys are longtime fans of Flight Sims, you know that feeling when you're in a storm, you're going through the most badass clouds, and then you break that peak of the ceiling about 10,000 feet. And the sun just blasts and you're on top of the storm. So cool. Cup of coffee in the morning. Right on. And so the weather, I'm very appreciative of the weather in the game. It's really good. It's really nice. Time of day will go daytime. Altitude, it doesn't matter. This is irrelevant. It doesn't seem to work. I can set this at whatever. And it's... The takeoff is, and I'm playing on realistic settings, and this is what I was saying. Arcade is pretty much straight up arcade. The computer flies the plane for you like 50% of the time, and I tried it out. I tried realistic. I also flew simulator, and the couple of things that I don't like about the simulator is hardest, I suppose. Like I said about 50,000 times, and I'll try not to repeat myself, I felt that the rotary pull was way too much, and I've flown damn hurricanes in Flight Sims for years, and I thought it was a bit much. And also the one shot kill shit, I get within 5,000 yards of a Heinkel and he's taking me out with one shot after I just spent 20 minutes tracking his ass down. So I don't want to do that. So realistic is normal. Realistic is middle of the road. And I find that this setting, realistic, is normal. It's not arcade easy, and it's not simulator expert. This setting I found to be the most realistic to simulator is somewhere about kind of like what IL-2 is like. What I don't like about this middle of the road normal setting is, as I've stated a million times like a broken record, I don't have control over a lot of my surfaces, which I should, like flaps, wheel brakes, et cetera, et cetera. Starts with the C. Our cowling in the front to open it up and to vent it. Like, we don't have control over some of that stuff, where I could manage things a lot better if I did. But the performance and the graphics is super. I'm digging it. Number of enemies. What do we got? We got four Heinkels, I think. Yeah, Heinkel 111, H2s. Battle of Britain, summer of 40, right? Probably July. We got 12 machine guns. We're flying a Hurricane MK2. Takeoff, yes, I guess. It's kind of takeoff. I like expert takeoffs. I like to take off for real. With wind speed, you know, looking at the sock, everything. Chocks on the wheels, you know, I like to land and take off. And that's another strange thing about how that affects the landing. Is that when I land, I use my flaps. I like to be in control of my flaps because then I can better control my airspeed. Also, I need that wheel brake. And I've noticed in this game, every single time that I've landed, as you're rolling to 0 miles an hour, right as you're coming to a stop, it tries to nose over. And I don't know, that's just really strange because these planes don't do that. In real life, they don't do that. That's weird. It's just arcade-ish, I suppose. It's weird. And so when I come into land, it's pretty easy to land. This is easier to land than IL-2 is, big time. This is really easy to land. It'll still like try to nose over at the last minute, and that's all right. So these suckers got 8 250-kilogram bombs. I've got fuel and ammo at unlimited because I am unloading 10 billion rounds. I unloaded every bullet in England into that Heinkel, and I was less than 2,000 feet away. And the sucker didn't go down. And I'm like, there's no way. I'm like, these guys are tanks. What do they got, like superpowers or something, right? Yeah, I'm opening up on these guys with like a million rounds, and I can smell what the guy had for dinner, and they're not going down. And then they're popping me right in the cowling, and I'm smoking out of control. So let's check it out. I think everything looks groovy. Yeah, so I got unlimited fuel, unlimited ammo. I'm gonna fly around, have some fun. And I'm still have a painful rib cage and shoot some enemies down. And then we're going to start our campaign. We're going to start our campaign. It's going to be awesome. And so without further ado, are you guys sick of me talking? Well, it's nice seeing you guys. Thanks for tuning in. What's for dinner, y'all? Oh. And you have mouse control. You have keyboard control. My costochondritis is freaking stabbing me. I'm good. Rock and roll. Cool. So we got mouse control if we want. Let's freaking light some fires, kick the tires. Let's go. Awesome. Yeah, it's a little bright, isn't it? You see, I don't have anything to do with the wheel brakes. I don't have anything to do with the flaps. The flaps would be controlled by the gear. It's so weird. Also, I've tried to fly under some bridges, and I'm probably yelling because I have the propeller sounds in my ears. And the music is really good. Let's turn on the music a little bit. I've got the music turned off, and it's very Hollywood music. It's good. It's great music. I have to be in the mood for it. I like the music. The music is incredibly well done. It's sunset over the Appalachians right now. And the music's good. I'd rather listen to like 1930s and 40s radio, which I've got tons of mixes I've made over the years. We could just listen to like real radio that these guys really would have been listening to. But the game music is great. So let's give it a listen until it gets overly epic, right? Right. You guys, I'm going to open up the curtains. Give me a minute. I'm going to get up. If I fall on my ass, come scrape me off the floor. I'm wearing pants. It's safe. Sun's going down, it's nice out. I hope I didn't leave my fucking hand outside. I probably did. I've got like 3 walking sticks sitting right here. I probably left my cane in the bathroom. There's 2 more right there. That was fun. Cool. Sun's going down, the sky is orange, and I'm gonna pay for that. Yeah, Right on, let's go. I dropped my cane somewhere. I remember one day freaking Dr. Greenbuds brought it to me. Let's go. Right. Nice. Loving it. We don't have any wingmen. I tried to fly under some bridges. No go. I'm not really sure we can. I'm not really sure we can fly under any bridges. I'm gonna get some altitude. That supercharger on. Almost 4,000 feet. Airspeed's 100. I freaking got it cranked. Heading's 143. I don't know. We're just on a patrol. We're supposed to have like four Heinkels rolling in. But I really want to fly around, check it out. My legs feel like there's someone trying to cut them off. And so what's the game? These guys went on to make the game War Thunder, right? So this was sort of a prequel to that. I'm gonna run into these Heinkels soon. Let's put Mr. Bean in the cockpit. I want to do something about those green clouds. Now I've got Cliffs of Dover Blitz, and I fly that once in a while, but I'll tell you what, tally ho baby, I see ya, tally ho, rock and roll. But I'll tell you what, Cliffs of Dover Blitz, it doesn't perform like this at all. And frankly, I think that this looks better. I wonder how high they are. I bet you they're freaking high as hell. Where we sitting, 12,000 feet? Where are these guys at? There they are. Yep, look at that. They freaking totally got altitude on me. It don't matter what I set that shit at. Yep, they're up there. Look at them. it's not overheat, huh? There we go. They always got the altitude advantage. It doesn't matter what I set it at. And that's all right. That's all right. That's right, Sonny. Let's go, go, go. Boy, this game looks good. Hot dog. Let's go get those freaking Heinkels. Good morning, boys. We've got some pork and kraut for you. Rock and roll. Have a good day, guys. Thanks for stopping in. How far are we? You're still a ways away. Right on. Hey! Thank you, but thank you. Right on. Constant semi was shaking, buddy. Thank you.
Keep your heads on a swivel, boys.
We're crawling. There we go. They're gonna start shooting at us. Let's get up to 150 airspeed.
Hot dog shit!
For we who are about to die, I salute you. The sky's orange out there. The sun's going down. Over the oldest mountains in the world. They are. Do you know how many times bears have pooped up there over the last 400 million years? These guys don't see me. Ho, 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 ho. There he goes. Watch it take me out in one shot. I'll pop my engine. I'll be done. Good morning, sunshine. Oh, here they come. Yeah, baby. Just like Halloween. Good day, sunshine. Oh, shit, shit. What are you waiting for? Come on, boy. I'm working on it, Captain. Shit, dog, slow down. Come on. Level out, level out. His fucking mate's nailing it. Go down, bitch. You fucker. He took our engine out. Yeah, he did. Eat it. Oh, look at our wing. Yep, took our engine out. Let's land this puppy. Where's our field? Let's see a map. Where we had it. Well, I don't want to go west. Let's head east. Whoa. Yeah, this is going to be a trick to land this puppy, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, they got me right in the cockpit. They got my right wing. They got my took my engine out. head towards the town. I need a big field. Some water. I don't want to ditch it in the drink, though. If I can land it, we can save the queen some money. That's right. Winston will be proud. You saved us a shilling, Daryl. Oh, dudes, we're in trouble. I'm doing 250. We're nowhere near a base. We have such a ways to go. Base is right up there. We might be able to catch the base. Maybe. Our wing is just history, man. Look at that. Shit, we're in trouble. Ah, we're gonna have a hell of a time landing this sucker. We're probably gonna die. I can see the runway. I don't know if we're gonna make it. Oh man, they tore me up. Man. Right on. So cool. I can see the runway. There's the base right there. Bitchin'. You have an awesome day. There's a nice field right there, isn't it? Yeah, it is. We'll go right in the water. Run into some farmer's house. Run to the cow, we'll be barbecuing some burgers. Be awesome. Rock and roll, look at this. Oh, we gonna make it? Shit, we're in big trouble. We might be going swimming. How fast are we going? Shit, we're really losing airspeed. Right there, right there, that's it. Oh, buddy. Oh, we're gonna be dipping here in about a second. There's a couple of hedgerows down there. Look at that road, right there, that road. I bet you it's bumpy as shit. Oh, this is gonna be bad. Holy hell. Oh, dude, are we gonna make it? Look at right there. Right there. Right there. Right towards the airfield. Right towards the airfield. Yeah. Now I need my flaps. See, I need my damn flaps, man. How fast are we going? 185? Ho, ho, ho. Shit, we're going way too fast. Whoa. Come on, come on, come on. Can we do it? Oh, dude, this wing. Look at our wing. Shit. Don't you flip on me, sunshine. Come on, look at that. Right back to the base. We're going to run into the damn hangar. Oh, dude. Oh, shit. Hey, man, we made it home. We made it home in time for dinner. Look at that. Look at that. We made it home. Shit. We just lost a wheel. Right. Let's go get these turkeys. Right on. Sweet. What a riot. Ah, looks so good. Right on. Ah, I miss flying. Bitchin'. this place so well too. Right on. Where's the ice cream shop? Get some height. I'm always running hot. There is no autopilot in this at all. I think when I died, I didn't complete a mission. It kind of went on a weird autopilot. I couldn't control the plane no more. It was after I died. It was like death cam or something. Ported from a console and it performs like a console. It does. So where'd these freaking cats go, man? It looks like we lost the enemies, huh? They're still cruising around somewhere. It'll spawn some more. The game. It. The game. I tried flying under some bridges. We should try to fly under some bridges again. I think maybe it's the way the modeling is that you can't. It's solid. Most flight games you can. I flew under London Bridge, man, and I put that on my YouTube channel, I think. And
what's your status?
Cliffs of IL-2, Cliffs of Dover Blitz. You can fly through London, fly under the London Bridge. Yeah, I think it was one Saturday or Sunday morning I was on Facebook and I was flying around. We flew under London Bridge. That was fun. But that thing, man, that Cliffs of Dover, the Blitz, that's a little resource intense for me, where this looks great. I think the landscapes look better. And a lot of people agree from what I've read, too. Love it. This landscape for... Let's, ooh, there they are. Let's go. Rock and roll. Yep, right above us too. way we headed south, southwest. There they are, they're behind us. Let's turn around. Right on. And if you're tuning in an hour later, thanks for tuning in. And if you rolled in to say, hey, gracias, make some good memories. Number one. Number one. Where are they at? 12,000 feet up. Way up there, man. Way up there. Let's keep chasing them. Get some seat time in. Octong Spitfire. Yep. Oh yeah, he's shooting at me. 13,000 feet away, he's already opening up on me. I'm crawling. Overheating my engine, running that sucker hot. It should have blown, I've already blown a few engines, shit. Yep, he's already shooting at me. Watch, it'll take me out before I even get there. That wind sounds awesome. Oh, we're crawling. We are crawling. Good morning. Good morning. Up and down. We are poor little lambs that have lost our way. Ba, ba. Shit, you bitches are turning. Don't you be turning on me. There we go. Good morning, boys. You're gonna freaking pop me in the noggin. Pop me in the noggin! can't see. Oh fuck, can't aim either. Come on. Watch, I'll stall out. Oh, you bastards, come on. Yeah, you are. Oh, I felt that from here. That rotary is pulling me off to the left. Let's go. We're under 2,000. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Pull that fucking trigger. You ain't shitting. Come on. Hold her steady. Don't grip it. Oh, you. Oh, 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 oh!
What are you waiting for?
Hush. Hush, Captain. Let's recover. Bullshit. Come on, bullshit. 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 I call bullshit on that stall. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Dude, I'm only doing 76 shit. Come on. Come on, recover. 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 Do I got damage? I probably do. There we go. Yeah, I do. Right in my horizontal stabilizer, my elevator. There we go. Right on. Let's go get these turkeys. We ain't done with them yet. That's right. Oh, where's the enemies, man? Where'd they go? Let's track them down. Looks like they might have gotten away. Let's head east. That's probably where they were going. Man, that was a gnarly stall. Holy shit. Oh, man. We lost him. Shit. We lost him. Let's see if we can track him down. Let's see if he'll spawn some more enemies. Let's see if we can fly to France. Attack Hitler. No siree, Captain. There they are. They still got altitude on me? Shit, I'm at 14,000 feet. Damn, these guys are freaking hugging the moon. Yeah, we got some serious wind up here, boy. I can feel that. That's pretty cool. Oh, there's a couple of them right there. Our airspeed's really, really slow. Let's get some speed, man. We need like 200 miles an hour, 250, 500, 500 million miles an hour. Come on, see that rotary turn? That's nice. It's not too extreme. When you're on simulator, that pull right there, that rotary, it's too much. Too much for me. Just let it float down. Pick up that 100 miles an hour again. East. Yaps, what's happening, buddy? Hey, happy birthday. Happy birthday. I haven't seen you to wish you a happy birthday. It was your birthday recently. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Gracias, muchacho. There they are. There they are. There they are, Yaps. We're going too slow. Yeah, I remember, it was your birthday. Happy birthday, buddy. You could be my uncle now. It's good to see you, Yeps. They're up there, they're right above me.
Number three, anything?
We're going the other way. There we go. I'm too slow. There we go. We're almost at a 150. There we go. Where'd these turkeys go, man? They were going inland. We'll find them. We'll find them. There's a couple of Heinkels flying around. We're hunting a couple of German planes. How do you read, Yepsy? How do you read, buddy? Let's get them. They're way up there. Way up there. They're at the moon. They're on the moon. Dude, no way. No way. Now we watch. We can't restart our engine. Come on. Restart. Wait, wait, wait. Did we just lose a propeller? No, we didn't. Come on, restart. Let's go. Come on, start that freaking engine. There we go, baby. Come on, start that puppy. Let's go, start her up. Come on, you can do it.
Number three, anything? No, negative, nothing. Roger that!
Oh, shit, come on! No way, would I run out of gas? I probably ran out of gas. Who forgot to fill the tank? Shit! I forgot to check the gas. Shit! Oh, we were ways from home, too. Come on, start that freaking engine, baby. Come on. Crank it, crank it. The Sherwood Forest right there. It's where Robin Hood lives. Shit, come on, fire up. Come on, fire up. Let's go, let's go. Come on, kick that engine on. Come on, crank it. Crank it. Crank it. That field right there. Come on, engine. Crank that engine, baby. Come on, come on, come on. Turn that engine on. Come on. Oh, we're gonna die. Oh, we're gonna die. There's nowhere to land. Shit, we're in trouble. Come on. Oh, our engine got shot out. Our engine shot out. We got our engine shot out. Either that or we blew our engine. We probably blew the damn engine. You see up in the icon in the left of the top by WEP? The engine cowling is black. Shit. Let's go for that far field. Right over that trees. Right over those trees. Right over those trees. Let's see. Anything else? Anything better? Anything better? Anything better? I can't see nothing either. Let's see. Where else? Where else? Right over there? Right over there? Ah, right there. Yeah, right over that hill. Come on! Get out there, climb out there on the airplane and turn the propeller. Or somebody's farm. They won't mind. Ah, shit, we're gonna hit those trees. Right. Damn. Hoo-wee. Shit, we're on somebody's airfield, huh? It's not our airfield, but damn, we landed on an airfield. How about that? We landed on somebody's army base. So it looks like we're in good hands. We're going to be peeling potatoes for about a week. Yeah. I don't know whose airfield it is, but shit, we made it. So can we take back off? So are we healed? Are we healed now? We can go back up in the air? Let's go get the mechanics out here. Did you hear that? Is it a plane flying by? He's probably gonna come bomb us now. He already shot our engine out. Now he's gonna bomb us. Ah, what a riot. Yeah, I wish we could open up the cockpit, right? Open up our hatch. We're having a hamburger. I hear you loud and clear, over. That's right, let's get moving. Shit, we're dead in the water. There's nothing we can do. Come on, you guys, where's the mechanics? Bail out. Let's bail out. We made it. All right, we got Big Macs and French fries. Let's go, go, go. Let's get these turkeys. Mandioca. The sun is going down. The sun's down. It's getting dark out. I'm glad I'm awake. Had such a struggle freaking staying awake today, man. I hate naps. Where's the M&M? We got M&Ms. We're flying over freaking Dover. I love it. Look at us. Oh, yeah. So cool. That fog. The fog. Awesome for the rain. Bitchin'. Very cool. Awesome. It's so cool. Love it. There's enemies rolling around here somewhere. Let's head back towards our base. We'll probably run into them there.
Number three, what do you have?
Can't see anything, sir. The coast is clear. Take care of that target.
Let's head back towards home. Yeps, how you doing? How's your weekend?
Let's move this, which way? This way? This way. There we go.
Whoa! Thanks for come flying the friendly skies, guys. Look at that wind, that gnarly. That's probably our wreck down there. 12 o'clock low. There's smoke down there in the field. That's probably where we crashed. I know we shot down two planes, I guess. I think we saw one of them go down. Trying to keep my hands steady, shoot the damn things. Trying to keep it vertical rather than horizontal when I'm opening up on them. They're around. Yeah, our base is right down there, 12 o'clock. Chill days, feeling okay. I've been sick, man, but I'm alright. I'm doing alright. I'm feeling better now. I've been on streaming, gaming a little bit. Had a rough couple of days sleeping, trying to stay awake, but I'm doing better. I'm doing good, man. I'm doing alright. My legs hurt, but I ignore it. Put some barbecue sauce on them. Always makes them feel better. I'm doing good, Yepsy. Thank you for asking, buddy. Happy birthday. Where's the enemy? There's still two enemies roaming around here somewhere. I'm getting tired of looking for them. They were right down in this area too. The 12,000 feet.
Jerry.
There they are. Let's finish the job. Spawned him right on top of me. Jeez, what is he, 20,000 feet up? He's gotta be. 17,000 feet. Freaking feet, holy cow. We're going to the moon. Look at him, he's already shooting at me. I think he thinks he lost me. Nope, he sees me.
Negative, nothing.
You need some airspeed. We're too slow. We're gonna stall. He's almost got me. Right in his freaking sights. That fucking rotary's killing me. Oh, bail, 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 buddy, bail, that's right, let's go. Hot diggity dog, parachute ride. Hoo-wee, hoo-wee, Louie, that was bitchin'. So where's my dude? My dude's flying around his parachute. Let's see where we're at. Oh, dude, he totally put us somewhere weird. Love it. Love it. This is great. Bitchin'. Home sweet home right there. There I go. There we are. Yep. There's little Warlord. There's little parachute. There's Warlord going home. Get some hamburgers. Some apple pie. Whoa, I'm blacking out. Blacking out. We're at 22,000 feet. Holy shit. Where's Jerry? I don't mean Jerry Garcia neither. Be nice. Play some Grateful Dead, fly around, rock and roll. Sweet. Come on, where's the enemy? It's a nice ride. GI. Welcome to the evening patrol. Boy, going through those clouds with the storms is really fun. I still want to go fly under a bridge though. We make it to London? Nope, not on this map. Let's see if we can go fly under the London Bridge. Those enemies gotta be around here somewhere. We're 20,000 feet. And watch, they'll have 10,000 feet on us. How they'd hit anything with a bomb at that altitude, man, I don't know. Crazy science. I'm not seeing these cats at all. Where's Jerry? One of them got shot down. One of them got shot down. I just gotta find these suckers. Headed back north. Come on, where's the enemies? I guess we'll land, shit. If we're not gonna see Jerry, we'll land, end the mission. Hey man, you're gonna go rest? Sleep well, buddy. I'll see you soon. I hope I see you streaming soon.
You're breaking out. See you again.
Yep, do me a favor. Give yourself a shout out. Please. And get some rest, man. Big hugs, Yeps, and happy birthday, young man. You'll always be my favorite uncle. Yeps, it's always good to see you. You always put a smile on my face. Oh, dude, I don't see any enemies. Dude, dream good dreams. Well, I don't see any more enemies. I'm not gonna fly around chasing. We could just go on a patrol, huh? You guys, gonna go on a patrol? We'll go fly around a little bit. Have a look around this bitchin' world. We're doing 450 miles an hour. think the Heinkels are gone. Whoa, that tripped me out. That little changeover. Hey, hey, hey. I'm patrolling. Shot down some Heinkels. Patrolling. Dover, we're headed way south. What's happening, Mercator? Patrol, and we had four Heinkels. There's a couple of Heinkels still roaming around somewhere. I can't find them. They may have headed home. That looks like smoke. Patrolling, kill the enemy. That's always the mission. Kill the enemy. And eat good food. Oh, looks like this is our prey. This was our prey. This is a couple of the Heinkels. I think we shot down two Heinkels, but I think two of them got away. They freaking hosed us though. Yeah, I crash landed, I think twice. I think I crash landed once or twice. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh, gnarly. Ooh, look at that. Oh, that's bad news. Ah, oh, somebody's having a barbecue. No, sir. Yeah, where's the target, man? I'm looking for the doggone guys. Yeah, we gotta head home. We're ways from home. Fly the coast, look for the enemy. We're sitting at 2,000 feet. I'm kind of sightseeing. I'm loving it. Love flying planes, man. Love flying planes. There's a good barbecue down there. Rock and roll, where's the enemy? Welcome to Dover. We're gonna go fly over the village of my ancestors. Look at the hills, so nice, look at that. The mission is nothing left to do but smile, smile, smile. That's the mission. Ah, man, I'm loving this. I'll tell you what, I love it. It looks so good and it performs so well. And like I said, a little bit of the flight model and the damage model is a little quirky, but it's something to get used to. A little less control on the player end, I suppose, and that's okay. Pardon me. I tried to fly under a bridge, but I exploded both times, but I should have cleared the bridge. So I'm wondering if there's no empty space there in the model. You know, there's no space to fly under the bridge. It's solid. It's an invisible wall. Because I want to do some barnstorming. Yeah, man. Some bridge diving. Rock and roll. That's probably where we crashed our Hurricane. We're drunk. We're flying around Dover. Bitchin'. Oh, there they are. Oh, let's go get them. Oh, gee whiz, he's right there. Hello, Uncle Heinkel. Uncle Heinkel. Punk rock band name of the day, Uncle Heinkel. Oh, look at you. Oh, he's gonna pop me right in the nose. He is. Watch. He's gonna shoot me right in the forehead. One shot, one kill. Feet. Let's kick into jams. Oh, look at you. I don't think he knows I'm there. Do it by the book. Compensate for the rotary. And then we'll just let that reticule just glide right up there. Now, if I can keep my fingers nice and just loose and light like feathers instead of gripping and squeezing and go vertical instead of horizontal. You see that? Slower down, baby. Yeah, good night. Oh shit, your engines are gone, aren't they? Oh, this. Oh, you bitch. Oh shit, dog. Go, 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 baby. Go, go, go. Go! Pull out of that stall. Come on. Oh, we're not done with you yet. Oh, look at that. He took my right wing. He popped me right in the nose. Yeah, he did. Yeah, he did. Oh, come on. We're not done with you yet, Sonny. Look like I got his engines, though. Oh, slower down a little bit. Yeah. Press the trigger! Thank you, Michael Caine! Yeah, baby! Oh, yeah, baby! Hot diggity shitbox McGillicuddies! Hot dog! Press the trigger and hit the silt, sunshine! Listen to him breathing. He better have his pants on. That's freaking creepy. Dude, I want to land the plane. You see, that was one of the peeves. I don't need the game. I don't want it to end. I want to finish the mission by landing the plane. You get a great big basket of fries waiting for us. That'd be awesome. We shot down all four of those bastards. Efficiency unbelievable. Not quite. I'm still really rusty. Three attempts. I suck. Look at that. 6,000 hours later, I finally shot a plane down. So yeah, I lost three planes. I shot down four planes. So my ratio, I suck. Ah, that's so much. That's so nice. That's so nice. So nice. Rock and roll. I love the replays. So nice. Dig it. Let's go, Mr. Bean. Move it, move it, move it. The activity I did today, boy, we always pay for it later. You guys know the drill. You guys work your asses off real hard one day. The next day, you're freaking hurting for certain. Let's go, sunshine. Move it. You got enemies to kill.
Yeah.
It's rock. IG. That's right. Rock and roll. Yep, replay. Flying around looking for the enemy. The mission is to get fat and happy. And thank you for asking, McCater. And happy birthday, all you guys. Everybody. That's right. The tilde button. And I can just go switch views. Bitchin'. Check it out. Awesome. I love flying planes, man. Look at these old birds. I prefer World War One. Love World War One. I'd love to see Red Baron reskin like this. Right? Is he gonna crash? Am I gonna crash? Warlord gonna crash? You see that IG? I gotcha. That's what it stands for. I gotcha. How's you guys this Sunday? I hope you guys had a good weekend. And please be safe in your week ahead. And I'm wishing you guys a successful week ahead and all your goals.
We're on course, on time, and on target. Everything's fine.
Especially if it involves tacos. Look at that. Look at that. Man, we're going to do some sightseeing. Look at us. Man, I can't wait to go to Sicily. Operation Husky, that's going to be cool. That's going to be different. Looking groovy. Yeah, I fly some more of these training missions. I'm gonna start a campaign. Boy, these glasses, my readers, they are freaking dirty. What the heck did I get on here? Barbecue sauce. It was so nice out earlier today. Our status is we are cruising around looking at the beautiful English countryside. Awesome, we're up here in Dover, bitching. Trying to figure out what aerodrome that is. So what is the oldest aerodrome in England? The oldest aerodrome in England. Originally it started with an S. I can't remember the name. It was like, it was very different. But today it is called RAF Digby, but it had another name back in World War One. And it's the oldest RAF aerodrome in England. Yeah, Digby. But it had a different name originally. It started with an S. Cool. Sure. Ah. No, we won't save that. That one was real long. Sicily mission. We should fly a Sicily mission, right? Lonesome Fellow, you're on a solo recon mission, right? My cup of tea. Oh, I can't wait to fly in the snow. Follow the waypoints over enemy territory. Piece of cake. So yeah, we're going on a recon. Spitfire, Octung Spitfire, 4 machine guns, 2 cannons. Weather is poor. That's not good. The bait. Our bombers are en route to attack an enemy bunker. Italian fighters are always roaming this area. You are to engage the enemy patrol. Cover the bombers. So I wonder, am I in charge of a flight? Because the commands are minimal, and that's good. The commands for your flight are simply 1, 2, 3, 4 on your keyboard. Attention, flight, regroup, attack, proceed to target, cover me. Yeah, there's like four commands. And also, it's very interesting because let's say you have a flight of 4 pilots. You can switch pilots, like you can body slide. Yeah, you can doppelganger into a different pilot. So even though I got 1 pilot flying to the target, I can swap and I can jump into a plane and somebody who hasn't taken off yet. And so that was interesting. And I'm assuming those are, say, like the 4 lives that you get for a particular mission. So yeah, there's some good missions here. According to invasion plans, all enemy fortifications along the designated stretch of the Sicilian shoreline must be destroyed. Enemy fortifications. So that's probably bombing, rockets. Yeah, 2 cannons and a 250-pound bomb. Good luck. You got 1 bomb. You better hit something other than sand. Indeed. Thanks for chilling, y'all. It's good to see all of you. If you guys rolled in to share the friendliness, thank you for being friendly today. It's a rough day. Use my legs for 5 minutes, I'll pay for it. I was in bed, but heck, man, I was flying and having some fun. I wanted to share the fun with you guys. It's a great game. I'm gonna take a restroom break and I need to get refresh my drink. And now a word from our sponsor. See you guys in a minute.
Even in death, my powers continue.
Rock and roll.
breathing pretty bad, Skip.
You better go back and see how bad it is.
Okay. Can you keep her in the air, Skip?
Yeah, sure.
Nelson? Following us.
What is it?
It's some kind of green meteorite.
What? Where? Okay.
Yeah, I'm coming back, Skip.
We are in business. I found my cane so I won't fall on my ass.
What the hell's happening back there?
See, that's what happened when you shoot my plane down. See, he should have drank his Ovaltine. I got my Ovaltine. Oh, you better run, Skip. I just wonder what happened in that plane. Look at that, it's an SE-5A. Thank you. Broadcasting seems to have been a little slow this week, and I haven't seen too many people on. People probably been out enjoying the spring weather. Ellie's on. Zach is on. Itchy's on. Irish is on. And of course, the Fro himself, Bob Ross. For dinner. I have a chicken, but it'll take me a couple hours to get that ready. Enjoying this game. If you guys are tuning in and you play a flight sim, what is your flight sim or flight game of choice? Or how about two or three of your faves? I need to fly some full squad missions. I don't really want to leave the flight though. That big net on. Looks good. And the haze. Motion blur I don't care for. Like to see the details. Thank you. melancholy mosquito. There we go. Now we got the full hangar view we didn't have before. When I first fired up the game, we started broadcasting tonight. We couldn't get this full hangar view. I don't know why. It was weird. I think that it's stuck in the last view that we were actually flying a mission. So we're flying a mission. Whatever the last view was that we were in that mission is the view that it stuck us with in this catalog. And so, yeah, if we really crank the textures up, this looks really, really nice. And I don't have the textures and stuff cranked up because I'm streaming. I mean, yeah, streaming, not streaking, streaming. Ah, look at that hot little ride. Oh, man. Can't wait to fly around in that. That's going to be tough. Yep, the old workhorse. Awesome. It's freaking cannons on that thing. Pardon me. Show us those Spitfires. Load. Come on, you can do it. Thank you. Oh, we can't zoom in. Let's see if we can zoom in using our controls. Load. See that? Magic. The windsock static. I saw her. This doesn't matter. The altitude, it doesn't matter. I don't want to be chasing him around all night.
Good, Kent. We were in Dover. All right. Spitfire, baby.
Towards the coast. Let's get some speed. Thank you. Our engine's hurting. My engine's giving out. Here it's stalling. Engine's clunking. Yeah, it is. How long is our engine going to last? We're doing almost 350 miles an hour, 17,000 feet.
You're breaking out. Stay again.
Damn, we are way south.
Reception 4, over.
That cockpit, heck yeah. Rock and roll. Octong Spitfire. Bitchin'. Let's let this baby's rip.
Tally-ho.
There he is, Tally Ho. Yeah, baby. There he is. Tally Ho is right. Is our engine gonna die? I think our engine's gonna die. Awesome. Where are you going, Jerry? Oh man, we are having some control issues here. What are we missing? What's damaged? Something's damaged. Yeah, something's hit. Yeah, my control is, look at that. See that bullet hole right in my cowling right there, right in my nose? Yeah, my wings. Shredded shit, dog. He's close. Let's not lose him. Her engine's hurting. Let's keep it out of the red. We might survive. We're having a hard time. Yeah, we are. We need some eight. We need some freaking speed. We'll ghost this sucker till we get some speed. Get up over 200 if we can. He's still shooting at us. He'll probably freaking take out our engine. And if I missed any chat tonight, I apologize. Sometimes I miss it, and sometimes that Stream Elements chat lags. Messages show up late all the time. Stream Elements, unfortunately. I like Stream Elements. A little tedious, but worth it. Man, we are just having a hard time. Our engine is just really hurting. Oh, yeah, our engine's really hurting, wasn't it? Yep, engine's gone. Yep, engine's gone. We got Hythe right there. Hawkins, yeah, Hythe's right there. There should be a base near there somewhere. Yeah, engine's done. Blew our engine. Yep, he popped us right there. You can see where he hit us. Right on the top of the engine, he got us. Let's see if we can see a base, a runway. Where? I see it. I see the base. Maybe that's an indicator to return to base. Let's see if we can find a runway. Right there. Yep, I see it. Cool beans, right there. Where are we at? I don't know. Yeah, there's an airfield right there. Yeah, right there. Ah, oh, we're way too high, shit. Oh, it'd be a miracle if we make that. We're way too high. Yeah, we ain't gonna be able to come around. There's no way. Yeah. Oh, we're gonna overshoot this sucker big time. Oh shit, our gears are jammed, shit. The field on the left. Our freaking wheels are jammed. We're too low to the ground to bail. So we're gonna swing and freaking do a loosey-goosey. Right here, baby. Let's do it. Rock and roll. Yeah, loosey-goosey is my delight. Oh shit, those trees. Damn it. Let's hop this hedge if we can. Oh. Come on, right over. Oh, we're not gonna make it. There's no way. Nope. Use the hell. Use the gravity. Dude, there's a farm right here. I bet you they're having a barbecue. Oh, yeah! Shit! Oh, come on. I didn't land that hard. I wasn't even doing 50 miles an hour. Ah, did you hear me? Did you hear me screaming? Oh man, that's what my legs sound like on a bad day. That was freaking nutty, man. Oh, freaking Warlord's down there screaming his freaking head off. Look at that. Whole field full of hops. Half of it's ruined now. Oh man. Let's go get this last guy. Shit, right over that hill. That was a close one. Our gear jammed. Our landing gear jammed. There's no way I was gonna bail out. There's no way we would make it. We had better chances in that cockpit with our seatbelt on. Rock and roll. Where are we at? Same spot. Are we down there dead? We're down there dead, aren't we? Yep, we're right down there. We're dead. Listen to that wind. Diggity dang. Look at that. Cool beans. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Ah, I love flying. Let's head back up to Hawkins. What do you have, sir? Let's get moving, sunshine. Can't see nothing. Nice. Somebody take care of that target. That's right. Let's get some altitude shit. We're only sitting at 3,000 feet. Look at that fog. Let's go check out that fog. That's where we're headed anyway. We got to go home back up to Hawkins. We got fog. That looks cool. See if we can buzz London. And by all means, drink your Ovaltine. Awesome. Awesome. I don't know what's up with the green clouds though, man. Pollution? Probably. From all the sack factories. London, where sacks were invented. Sacks and Bagginses. Awesome. Let's go up here. There we go. I never say I never took you guys anywhere.
You're breaking out. Say again.
Sunday night flight over Dover. Man, we need some freaking altitude, don't we? Yeah, we do. The joke back in the 90s and we were doing multiplayer flight sim combat tournaments for the first time on the internet back 30 years ago, 25 years ago. The running joke was always, is that an enemy contact on the screen or a gnat? There's a dot on the screen. There's an enemy. I swear it's there. It was there a second ago. No, it wasn't a gnat. It was not a fly. It wasn't a fruit fly. It wasn't a chinch bug. 11,000 feet, rock and roll. Let's go, go, go. 200 miles an hour. We overshot Hawkins. I thought I saw it down there.
Tally-ho.
Right on, tally-ho. Let's go, go, go. Yep, there's base. The blue line up on the compass. Freaking spawned right on top of me. Where'd he go? He freaking disappeared. Shit. Yep, I lost him. He was a blip in the sky. We got the tally-ho, but then he flew the coop. Stick around base. It is right on top of it. There she is. Fucker. Shot the sucker. Beating on us. He shoots. Come on, get in line. Terrible, Warlord, terrible. I'm all over the place. There we go. He's gonna fucking kill me.
Open fire.
Gotcha. He got our engine. I wish it would let us land. Doggone. I guess I have to play it on full sim. So let us land. Fly home. Make sure our landing gear is still working. Unbelievable. One attempt. Two kills. Unbelievable. A half an hour too long to shoot down two planes. Man, that sure is bitching. You stopped in to say hey tonight. Thanks for rolling in. Chilling or lurking. Dream good dreams wherever you may roam. was fun. Right on. Sing it if you know it. Dance if you don't. Number one song in Gettysburg. British pilots that the world could hope to have. Binky, Stinky, Squiffy, Brandisek, and Stanislav. Hold fire, is that some foreign chaps risking their necks? That's right, some of the bravest men were Polish and Czech. We horrible histories. I love this song, it's ridiculous. Dance! Saw Nazi invasion of just as I'm sure. Heard our bravery meant Hitler wouldn't be back for good. No, no. We beat the Fuhrer. Without us frequent flyers, your life would be poorer. Yeah, yeah. Return secure. Our story of heroics will forever endure. Well, yeah. So I think you'll find it's true.
Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few.
Clutch Cargo with his pal Spinner and Battlefoot in another exciting adventure, the case of Ripcord Van Winkle. Our scene opens on an old deserted hangar near the little Midwestern town of Weedsville. Once the center of busy flying activity.
Home
Some
sweet
say
home.
The place is haunted.
That's
few
right.
Remember the
you
legend of
rough.
Its colorful past. Who was that? Is that the ghost of Weedsville Airport? What's this? An announcement. Why, somebody's planning to put on an air show. And it's starting tomorrow.
Take a look at this, Clutch. I just received it through the mail.
Why, this is the same kind of air circus announcement they used to have 30 years ago.
Yeah, and that old handbill smells kind of musty, too.
It must be some kind of a joke.
Could be, Clutch, but it might be worth checking into. On the back of this handbill, it says planes of all descriptions will be in this air show. Wacos, Travelairs, Great Lakes, Spads, Jennies, Gypsy Moths, Bull Pups.
Bull Pups?
Yes, Spinner. Those early planes had very colorful names.
Clutch, There's a story here I want you to check into.
Well, I don't know. But you're the boss, Tom. Come on, Spinner. Let's see what's with Wheatsville.
Indeed.
The handbill says this air show is being staged by a fellow named Ripcord Van Winkle. Who's he, Clutch?
I vaguely remember. Seems to me he was a hot pilot back in the early years. Mysteriously disappeared right after an air show about 30 years ago.
Disappeared? Golly! He must have come back like an old ghost!
How could an old pilot who disappeared for 30 years suddenly come back from nowhere and throw an air show? This looks like Wheatsville country, all right?
Yeah, and lots of wheat fields and corn.
Ah, there's the Wheatsville airport dead ahead, right on course.
That's an airport? Looks more like an old barn than a wheat field. Sure looks deserted. Where are all the planes for the air show?
Mighty strange, Spinner. We better go down and drag the field and see if it's safe to land.
Good old clunker.
I don't see a soul anywhere. What air show is this gonna be?
I don't understand, Spinner. We've got the right place and the right date.
Hey, Clutch, look. Here comes a plane now.
Looks like he's going to buzz the field.
Hey, he's coming right at us.
Hit the dirt, Spinner. He's gonna fly right into the hangar.
Uh-oh, an old plane diving at them. How can they escape being hit? Be sure to tune in for the next exciting episode with Clutch Cargo.
Indeed. Right on. Love that, Clutch. It's mighty quiet in here, my friends. I've been out for a while. I'm going to say goodnight to all of you. I see Itchy's on. Let's go see what he's up to. And thanks for joining me. I might see you tomorrow. Probably be outside if it's nice. And if you're still tuning in, thanks for tuning in. And I'm gonna rest. It's been a rough day. Let's go see what Dauntless is. See you soon, y'all.
Did you get the one that spawned? Yeah, I got that spawn. So far, I think I've gotten all the obvious spots. I'm gonna head out, so you have a beautiful night. Yo, MS Warlord, what's up, dude? You just hopping off for the night? Let me give you a shout out. I just made some food and swapped games since my friend got off. And I haven't played this game in forever. I kind of wanted to get back into it, and I was gonna play. Oh, there it is. There we go. Daily's done. How is your game? You're playing.